Hello everyone, this video is in continuation with my last video that was about the sacred group. And in this video, I am going to explain you some of the important religious plants which are considered sacred and worshipped by the tribes as well as the local people. Student, our ancestors were very knowledgeable and they have intelligently declared all the important plants, especially medicinal plant, as a sacred plant, to ensure their availability and conservation in near future. Student, as our ex-president APJ Abdul Kalam rightly has said that Indian people are very religious and we should relate our developmental activities like cleanliness as well as plantation with the religion for ensuring effective development. So I think this is his very good suggestion to follow. Student, Indian worship many important plant in various religious ceremonies, rituals as well as festivals. For this, they either cultivate plant near to home, around the temple or in forest. So let's know what are the plants which are considered sacred and worshipped by the tribes as well as local people of the Mandi area. Important plants of sacred value are, first one is banyan tree. It is known as Ficus vangelensis botanically and it symbolizes the Trimurti, that is Lord Vishnu, Shiva and Brahma. It also symbolizes life and fertility in many Hindu culture. This is the reason the banyan tree is worshipped by those who are childless and it is believed that this tree should never be cut. Student, there are example of some old and large banyan tree. For example, banyan tree present in the National Botanical Garden, Kolkata. This tree is 200 year old and its canopy is spread over 4-acre area. That's why the tree is known as Great Indian Banyan Tree. Next sacred plant is bale. Botanically, this is known as Azil marmols. This is frequently cultivated by locals around their home and temple for its religious value. Whole plant is considered a sacred tree by the inhabitants and its leaves are indispensable offering to the Lord Shiva during famous Shivratri festival of the northwestern Himalaya. Student, here are images of Bilpatri tree. You can see in second image, its leaves are offered to the Lord Shiva. And in third image, women of self-help group are selling its leaves outside the Bhutnath temple. This is a good source of earning for the women because they can sell leaves during every Monday fast as well as in Shivratri festival as well as in Savan Mahina. Next religious plant is bamboo. It is represented by its species Dendrocalamus strictus as well as Phyllostachys aurea. The common name of Lord Krishna, Venugopal, Bansilal, Muralidhar reflects his association with the Bansuri. That is a flute made up of bamboo. According to old people, this is the plant which is used from birth of young one to the death of an individual. Bamboo wood is used in various religious ceremonies. This is the image of the bamboo. Next sacred plant is banana, that is also known as Kela locally. Botanically, this plant is known as Musa paradisiaca. Though banana is not a tree, but considered a tree due to its structure and size. Whole plant is considered sacred and its leaves are used to distribute prasad and food in social gathering. Fruits are offered to God during worship. Tree is worshipped in Thursday fast. Student, you can see in these images, first one is the jungli kela, while second one is the cultivated kela. Next sacred plant is bhang, that is known as Cannabis sativa botanically. Student, bhang leaves are considered sacred and along with bilpatri tree, it is used to worship Lord Shiva. Bhang leaves are also considered indispensable offering to the Lord Shiva and worship during famous Shivratri festival of the Mandi town. Next sacred plant is mango. Botanically, it is known as Magnifera indica, and locally it is known as aam. Aam is considered as a sacred plant and its leaves are used in decoration of worshipping place during fast, festival and newly built houses. Its wood is used in making abode of the god, chokki, and branches are used in havana. So student, here is a chokki made up of mango wood, and you can see in this pot mango leaves are placed for worshipping. Next religious plant is tulsi. Student, we all know that tulsi is a sacred plant in Hindu belief, and Hindu regard it as an earthly manifestation of the goddess and the avatar of Lakshmi. So it is cultivated and worshipped by every Hindu. Student, tulsi vivah is a ritual performed by most of the local people, where the marriage of the holy vessel is done to the Hindu god Shaligram or Vishnu. The tulsi wedding signifies the end of the monsoon season and the beginning of the wedding season. This marriage ceremony of tulsi is performed in Kartik Purnima. Student, it is represented by two or three species in Himachal Pradesh, and the plant you are watching in this image is Osimum sanctum, and in second image you can see tulsi vivah being performed in Kartik Purnima. Student, next sacred plant is Daru. Locally it is called Daru and botanically we call it Punica granatum. This plant is considered sacred by some people, and this plant is worshipped in marriage ceremony that is known as Bharadi Pujan. During this Bharadi Pujan, both bride and groom, they worship this plant for their healthy and happy life. Student, next plant is Ficus racemosa. It is also called Umri locally, and it is also considered a sacred plant, and its leaves are used in worship along with mango and peepal. Name Umri signifies that it increases the age of an individual, or aging effect is reduced significantly, means by consuming this plant you will remain young. And see, except spiritual uses, it also has medicinal and edible uses. In this image you can see Umre plant, its fruits and its leaves being used by a parish during the religious ceremony. Student, next sacred plant is Asparagus racemosus, that is called Satavari or Sansarpali locally. This plant is also considered a sacred plant and worshipped in many religious ceremonies, especially in the marriage. Due to its heavy extraction, this plant is become rare or endangered in many areas. So people used to cultivate this plant in a pot and shift this plant wherever any worship or marriage is going on. So this is a very good idea to conserve important plant like asparagus. Except spiritual use, it is very important medicinally as well as has edible uses. It is considered as a tonic and it helps to reduce stress or boost immune system. Next religious plant is Kuri. It is botanically called as Kalium aperin. This plant is worshipped in Sair festival. Next plants are citrus species, locally called as Khatta. The fruits are worshipped in Sair festival, while its leaves are used to worship home during various religious ceremonies, that is known as Patri Dhalna locally. You can see here in this image, citrus fruit is being worshipped in the Sair festival. Next religious plant is Colocasia asculenta, that is known as kachalu locally. This plant is also worshipped in Sar festival. You can see in this image. Next plant is walnut, locally called as khod or botanically juglan rizia. Fruits are worshipped in Sar festival and its wood is used in making abode of the god. Its fruits are the mainly fruits which are worshipped and exchanged in the Sar festival along with the dhruv grass. Next religious plant is jia maize, locally called as makki or challi. This plant is also worshipped in Sar festival along with the oriza sativa, that is called dhan. Next religious plant is taur. It is called as fenravali or bahuniavali botanically. Leaves of this plant are used in almost every worship to place lamp and other religious items. Leaves are used to distribute prasad and food in social gathering. So you can see here, this is the dunnu, which is made up of bahuniavali leaves. Except this religious value, it is also edible and have medicinal uses. Next religious plant is amla, that is botanically known as Phyllanthus amblica. Student, its fruit, wood and whole tree is considered sacred and worshipped by the local people. Fruits are worshipped during Kartik Purnima fasting. On this day, amla fruits are floated during evening hours in water bodies like ponds, streams and river along with the walnut or dhruv grass. Flowers and lightened lamp are also kept in the bowl or container that is called dunnu, and this dunnu is made up of bahuniavali, that is tall leaf, or tarambal leaf, that is called ficus auriculata botanically. In old days, dal khichdi is prepared under the amla tree, and I can still recall the days of my childhood where we used to prepare dal khichdi below the amla tree in a natural habitat, and this time is a great fun for all of us. But later on, people used to bring fruits laden in branches and kept them some distance above cooking container as a symbol of amla tree. This dal khichdi is known as amle thaleri khichdi in local dialect. Kids were also used to prepare this dal khichdi during their play under the tree. But nowadays, this practice seems to be extinct. Wood of amla tree is considered sacred by the local and they use it along with the wood of palash, butia monosperma and chandan, centellum album in havana and in cremation ceremony. Student, amla fruits are also used in tulsi vivah as a main offering. So you can see in this image, amla fruits are being sold in the market for the tulsi vivah. Here you can see amla fruits growing wild, and in this image you can see amla fruits being placed in a tarambal dunnu for worshipping. Next religious plant is red sandalwood tree or santalam album. Its wood is considered sacred and used in havana and as a kumkum. Next plant is kotha ghas, botanically called as Lucas lanata. This plant is also worshipped in Sar festival. And student, again this plant has become rare or endangered due to its huge exploitation and it need conservation. Next plant is Bombax sativa, that is called cymbal locally. Student, its wood is considered sacred and used to prepare bedh and chowki. Bedh is the structure which is used in marriage ceremony. Next religious plant is tirmire. Botanically, it is known as Xanthoxylum armatum and it is known to have very important medicinal values. Its stick is used in marriage ceremony to perform a ritual in which groom has to play the role of a yogi and beg food items from the family members and the relatives. This tirumirai stick is used by yogi groom and his brother or cousin brother for begging. Only tirumirai stick is used in this ritual because it believed to keep evil spirit away. Student, you can see in these images tirumirai stick being used by monk, by dulha, and the tirumirai plant is cultivated in botanical department. You can see in first image. Next religious plant is paja. Botanically, it is known as Prunus sarsoides. Its branches are used in marriage ceremony. Below its branches, bath is taken by the bride or groom. Next religious plant is Hordeum bulgare, that is called jaw, and these greens are used in havana. Next plant is Brassica nigra, that is called sarson locally, and seeds are considered sacred and used in various religious ceremonies, especially in havana. People use its seeds to keep evil spirit away. Next plant is Vitis negundo. This plant is again considered sacred and its sticks are used to keep evil spirit away. Next plant is Til, botanically called Sesamum indicum. Its seed and oil is used to perform various rituals. Next plant is Phegra or Khasra, botanically called as Ficus palmata. Twigs of this plant are used by monk to keep evil spirit along with the bana twigs. Students, especially this type of fig tree, that is Phegra tree, is useful which have palm-like leaves or whose leaf is dissected. You can say many varieties of fig are there, and this variety is specially used for the religious ceremonies. Student, next 10 plants or 9 plants we are going to read are used as a nabgra plants, and they have special religious values, so are cultivated many religious people as a nabgra batika. And first plant is Calotropis procera, locally called as Akh. It represents sun or surya and planted in the middle or center of the garden or the place you have chosen for the nabgra batika. So student, you can see this is the plant here. It is mainly the plant of tropical regions where it grow wild, but you can also cultivate this plant too near to your home or garden. Next is Butea monosperma. This plant is known as Palash and it represent moon or chandra. It should be planted in southeast direction. Its wood is used in havana. Plant is also very beautiful, so you can cultivate it as a ornamental plant. Next plant is Acacia cachu, that is called Khair locally. It represent Mars or Mangal and should be planted in south direction. Here is image of Acacia cachu, that is called Khair. Earlier this plant is present in the botanical garden, but with passage of time it is uprooted. Next plant is Acranthus asper, very very important medicinal, edible and religious plant, locally called as Putkanda. It represent Mercury or Buddha and should be planted in north direction. Student, whole Putkanda plant is considered sacred and it grow wild. Inhabitant of the western Himalaya worship this plant in many religious ceremonies. Local people of Mandi area worship this plant in famous Sayar festival along with other plant. Putkanda stem and leaves are used in worship during closing ceremonies of various fasts like Hari Talika. Whole plant or its stick is indispensable offering in the havana. Student, you can see here images of Putkanda plant. First is the plant bearing seeds. Second is the image of the image where Brahmins using this plant to worship, especially leaves and stem are used in worship in the fast which they perform when their periods are over. Next you can see plant is being worshipped in Sar festival. So this is an important plant, that is Acranthus asper. Next religious plant is Ficus religosa. We all know that peepal is very religious plant for Hindus and it represent Guru or Jupiter, and it should be planted in northeast direction. This tree is a symbol of Trimurti, root being Brahma, trunk Vishnu and the leaf Shiva. This is worshipped since a long time by all. Leaves are also used in decoration during every religious worship, and wood is used in Havana. Next plant is Ficus racemosa, which I already explained to you. It represents Venus or Shukra and should be planted in east direction. Very important plant for its edible and medicinal uses. Next plant is Prosopis cinerea, also known as Khari. It represents Saturn or Shani and should be planted in west direction. Here is image of the Khari, also called as, botanically also known as Prosopis cinerea. Next plant is Dhruv grass, Cynodon dictylon. Student, you all know very well that this plant is very important and used in every worship. It represents Rahu or dragon head and should be planted in southwest direction. This herb is used in almost every worship and is mainly exchanged with walnut in Sar festival. Student, last plant is Imparsha cylindrica, that is called Drabha or thatch grass. It represents Ketu or dragon's tail and should be planted in northwest direction. You can see image of this plant. It is a grass, especially a perennial grass which perennate by rhizome, and it is used to make drabha, that is used in various religious ceremonies. So student, this is list of 35 religious plants which are used by the people of Mandi area in various religious ceremonies. So you can list all these plants, try to identify these through these images and recall their botanical name. Student, you can also collect or list up important religious plants which are being worshipped in your surrounding. So I hope you understood this topic. Thank you. Thank you very much for listening.